Hey, what's up? It's Jim, and today I'm going to talk about Shrek Retold. And this is the winner of the Patreon movie review vote. If you would like for me to review a movie of your choice, then click on the link below and pledge, and maybe I'll be reviewing your movie next month. Shrek Retold is interesting in that it is a crowdsourced shot-for-shot remake of Shrek. I've seen Star Wars Uncut before and reviewed it. I was in Empire Strikes Back Uncut. I saw the RoboCop Uncut, which nobody talks about anymore, but had that popular video of a guy getting shot in the dick. And there's obviously the Raiders thing that a bunch of kids made before we had the internet of them shot for shot making Raiders of the Lost Ark. And I've seen that. So I've seen a few of these remade kind of films before. And I always kind of liked the animated parts of all of them a lot more than the live action ones. They're a lot more interesting. If you think of how many different animators there are and different animation styles, having that all kind of cobbled together in itself could be a really cool and interesting watch. And Shrek Retold doesn't disappoint. Not every shot is animated. They have a lot of live action, a lot of green makeup, which can get really annoying and tiring and stupid after a certain point. But it comes back around a lot of times. You're like, oh, I actually like that part, but then I'm getting tired of it, and then someone will be funny again, so that works out fine. But it kind of is an interesting idea, remaking Shrek, in that Shrek and this whole idea of what Shrek sort of represents as a film, because Shrek was very hailed in its time. It was the first animated film to win Best Animated Feature. It actually got a screenplay nomination for Adapted Screenplay. It was very much hailed at the time, and a lot of people really loved it, and definitely got overwatched because I think it was an animated film's parents kind of liked. So if they're like gonna have family movie night, I think a lot of people, as I recall at the time, I was kind of a lot older, but whenever I talked to like parents who had young kids or kids or something, they'd say, yeah, we've seen Shrek a lot of times. And sort of what Shrek represents is this kind of cynical parodying of the traditional fairy tales of Disney, which are very genuine and sincere. And Shrek was never really that. And I kind of wonder what it's like to be a kid who, since I grew up with the genuine and sincere stuff, what it is like growing up with the cynical parroting postmodern stuff, and what your view of fairy tales would be if that is sort of, in a lot of ways, your introduction to it, because people were like, it's a kids movie, so kids will see this. But at the same time, this is how kids are introduced to storytelling, is that you parody other stuff. And what does that do to your view of things? Now, I'm not saying that's like bad necessarily, but it's definitely going to skew your context quite a bit. And I think Shrek Retold shows what it's like to have grown up and then eventually make Shrek memes. And I think Shrek had this sort of evolution from being this film that everyone took very seriously and it was acclaimed and, you know, helped launch a major animation studio and all this stuff. But then there were sequels and it was mass merchandised and became this stupid, silly corporate nonsense thing that was everywhere, and so people started making fun of it because they're like, this was a thing we all took very seriously at one point. And I think since the kids who grew up with that sort of in a way had to deal with all of that, it definitely made an impact on culture, and especially fairy tale things. Look at everything from Enchanted to how Tangled or Frozen deals with those issues as well. But I think the kids who had to watch it all those times, who it made money off of, have sort of an interesting view of things, particularly when it comes to the internet, and I guess by way of Tim and Eric, which a lot of this really is. And that makes Shrek Retold kind of the Dadaist extreme version of where that is all going, and I kind of love it for that. You know, I see a lot of these crowdsourced things and you get really bored of them because essentially you can sort of remember the movie through them, and that gets stupid because you're like, why don't I just watch that? Why don't I just watch that movie? Like, why am I doing this? And I think Shrek Retold, there's a lot of scenes where like I've seen Shrek a bunch of times and I was completely lost where I was, and because they're going off into such weird, bizarre tangents, and I love that about it. I don't know how many of these crowdsourced, I haven't seen everyone, but from what I have seen of them, very few of them are willing to take as many liberties as Shrek Retold really did. And even when it is trying to do it in more of a straight way, they push it in an interesting way. A YouTube guy named Hot Dad made a really cool I'm a Believer kind of synth new wavy cover, and I really love that. Like, there's a lot of scenes where I was like, oh, I hate this scene, but I love the Shrek Retold version of it because it takes it in this bizarre way, all these different animation styles, all these different ways of covering scenes from Christine Chan to apparently Anthony Santana's in this. I missed him somehow. Maybe that's when I dropped my phone or something. I don't know. There's a lot going on in this movie. And supposedly there's a lot of other internet celebrities who I'm sure someone in the comments will be like, come on, Jim, you forgot about this person or whatever. But I think the whole collaborative nature of the piece, which is put together by Grant Dufferin, who's also responsible for Shrek Fest, I don't know, seems to really enjoy Shrek and the fandom and its parody and its reaction to other kind of things, which, hey, makes sense because Shrek is a reaction to Disney. Some say it's Jeffrey Katzenberg's cynical satire on Disney after he was sort of a total dick to them. Seriously, look it up. And then decided to make very much a parody of them while also getting $100 million severance fee. Shrek Retold is worth a watch. I would say, to be honest, if you like or grew up with Shrek, I'm sure you'd like it more than I did because I was like a senior in high school when Shrek came out. So it was like, you know, I saw it at a drive-in. Yeah, I was like, that's better than I thought it would be. And I did get it on DVD and I watched it a few times. But it wasn't, you know, didn't represent a big part of me. I was like, I enjoyed it. I watched it probably more than I ever should have. And I moved on from it because the Shrek 2 looked really bad and stuff. It kind of gets into the hilarity of Shrek, I think. You know, that's the whole point of it, is like, let's take this thing that is a parody and is a satire, and instead of just making it sort of part of the norm that the genuine stuff was, which is sort of its actual evolution, let's push it to the actual area that it is more comfortable in, which is satire and a reaction to things, and let's make Shrek a reaction to, you know, cosplay or conventions or even the kind of community crowdsourced kind of movie. And in a lot of ways, I think that's what makes this in particular so good, is in a reaction to those kind of things, they're being less and less genuine and more ironic and more postmodern. And that's exactly what Shrek probably needed, if you're really going into it and wanting to make a statement on Shrek and its everlasting effects on society, is it's a postmodern ironic one. It is a satirical one. It is, what is it like to grow up with these sort of reactions to things? And wouldn't you and yourself, since the people who made Shrek are reacting to things from their childhood, what was your childhood growing up with Shrek? How do you react to that? And I think this is a natural evolution to it. You can't naturally make an animated film like this because it gets dark, it gets weird, it gets strange, it gets confusing, but it is all the ways kind of the weird art theory, bizarre, kind of crazy tangent of what a Shrek retold and what a Shrek reaction should be, and probably not the one Jeffrey Katzenberg would ever watch and say, come on, who actually wants to watch this, because apparently 4 million people. But I think that kind of is what makes it sort of so special. So I think Shrek Retold is probably the best crowdsourced film I've ever seen. I don't love these movies. I don't really need to watch them. I think I watch like one every couple of years. I don't need to do any more than that. They're kind of fun as a weird kind of experiment. But I think Shrek Retold might have the best reason to exist and have the most theoretical statement to give. And I think that's what makes Shrek Retold kind of the unique, kind of weird-ass, crazy, different styles of filmmaking animation that it is. I just wish there was maybe a little less live action in it, but maybe that's missing the point entirely. Maybe it should be all over the place and be the exactly kind of beautiful, multi-layered onion that it is. So if you've seen Shrek Retold and you would like to talk about it, then comment below in the comments and subscribe if you would like to. So I was actually, because I'm hardcore, I actually got to watch this on VHS right here. So there'll be a link. Someone sent this to me, not the person who suggested this in the movie review vote, but someone else sent me this copy. So I watched it on VHS. And even though I can't find my tape player today, sent me this tape of the Shrek soundtrack. So, or the Shrek Retold soundtrack, sorry. So check those out. They're nice of them to send them to me. So there'll be links in the description. And if you would like for me to review a movie of your choice, then click on the link below and pledge, and maybe I'll be reviewing your movie next month. Thank you very much for watching.